healthcare has relied on humans making medical decisions for millennia. Healthcare is becoming too expensive. There's an almost infinite demand for healthcare, and we don't have enough doctors. And finally, healthcare is very unequally distributed.
I personally think that the best way to derive value in the healthcare space is to go for full autonomy. When I think about the way autonomous AI is going to develop in the healthcare space, I see a big future.
Digital Diagnostics as a company focuses on bringing specialty healthcare into primary care and other places where the patient is through autonomous artificial intelligence.
For a patient that is used to having to do multiple visits, we're trying to make things more convenient and accessible to the patient.
What we're doing with the AI is taking these low-level components of their day-to-day and then really letting those specialist providers practice to the top of their license, allow them to do what they went to medical school for.
Practitioners have been intimidated about artificial or augmented intelligence that could be used to replace the physician. But what AI is gonna do is increase accessibility to healthcare. It's gonna increase awareness of eye diseases, and it's gonna identify patients out there with undiagnosed diseases who do need in-office care, whose outcomes can be improved by our unique skill set, the stuff that we can provide as eye care practitioners.
The device that Digital Diagnostics developed is called IDXDR. It allows anybody with a high school level education to administer. The device itself detects signs of serious eye disease called diabetic retinopathy, and it's the most common cause of vision loss and blindness in the working population of the United States. Our AI device looks for biomarkers, and biomarkers are basically signs of the presence of disease. Our AI system basically instructs the operator of the device exactly what to do. It gathers all the information and brings it together, forms a diagnosis, and sends that information back to the operator so that it can be shared with the patient.
Healthcare is a decidedly ethical industry. How can we be sure that a machine not doing healthcare remains ethical? And so we have to look at bioethical principles. We need to make sure that the AI works equally well for different groups. It's equally accurate.
If we were to only use, for instance, images from Caucasian people to train the algorithm, when we apply it to retinal images from people with a different skin color, the performance of the system might be different. So that was a very important challenge that we had to overcome.
So I think one thing that's important for people to understand here is the whole premise of how everything is built is around removing bias from how the algorithm's built, making sure regardless of your ethnicity, you're getting the same quality outcome or diagnostic coming out of the product. It's something that's both built equitably and creates an equitable healthcare distribution result in the end.
Hey, sir.
Michael, good to see you.
It's understandable that you think, well, is this safe? And it means making sure the quality is high through clinical trials to make sure that their data is being used appropriately by being very transparent about what happens to their data and how the AI is built.
The company engineered this device to meet the highest US and international standards for medical device software.
We've been thoughtful about how to be disruptive, right? It's not just disruption for disruption's sake. We fit seamlessly into their workflow, and we've worked with all these key stakeholders to do AI the right way so that people would want to continue to support us over the years to come.
In light of the current pandemic, I have found it useful as well to refer patients that are scared to go into a separate appointment to see an eye care professional to have their eyes dilated and have another screening test that way. Explaining to the patient what exactly the technology is, so explaining to them that it is AI and that what their possible results will be has been helpful in easing any potential confusion or apprehension about having this screening test done. it allows our patients to have a screening in a timely manner and allows our patients to be referred to the appropriate eye care professional prior to them having any visual disturbances as a result of diabetic retinopathy.
I'm very happy that, you know, Digital Diagnostics is a company that really takes patient safety very seriously. And we have a very passionate group of engineers and scientists and people working in the company.
I see that as the best way of bringing healthcare to where the patient is. It also leads to lower cost and better quality. It also improves access for underserved communities and can help solve health disparities, meaning that some people get better healthcare than others. Using AI, you can avoid that because you can bring high quality healthcare any place where the patient is.